My big box got me feeling so bossy. Like Lauren Hill, me I kill them softly. This a girl rather fi be called a naughty. Cause if my too loyal, then it's gonna cost me. And
this is how I feel.
Yeah.
That's how I'm feeling.
That's how I feel.
Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling. Big boss, I'm a big boss. Up north, brick rolls. I got the pump that'll make you jump.
Tonight, from Las Vegas, Nevada, Super Bowl 58.
Super Bowl 58 off and running from New Orleans. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
Chart. How did do on third down, that's a nice start for them in this one.
On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. They'll return it from the six. See if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be set around. That first series, everybody goes out of Lawrence for emotion. So now we get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You guys go rolling in there on that first drive.
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity, nothing big happened, but then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go.
Shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens things up for you.
Mayfield on third and two. Man open, that's Anthony Schwartz. He's able to get this one over the screen before he's out of bounds. So first and 10 now from the 30. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yards back to the 29. He'll lose a yard there and it's second and 11.
Defensively, he's been a presence in their backfield in the first half. Had a sack earlier, and now he comes up with a big tackle for a loss.
Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. Back to the ground. This time it's Chubb. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. Threat of a second straight punt to start the game is looming as they come up third and 10. Here's Mayfield. Some people may not realize it. It's really like an extra linebacker, right?
It really is, because they're hybrids. Half linebacker, half defensive back. The linebacker in them are not fully merged.
And second down, it's a 58-yard punt. And that will come the offense as they take over. Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
Working with a second and three. Send out their punter as he'll punt it away for the second time. This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And this one goes in and out of bounds. This one inside the third. about to get started. We've seen both of these offenses just sort of in that figuring things out phase, but I suspect some action on the scoreboard soon as they start out here first and 10. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Sometimes just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness. He's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Found a little room there as he's out to about the 37. We're scoreless after one. Three thus far. Here it's third and two. They'll run for it. Here's Chubb. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. Just a one-yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's fourth down. Offense at the line. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. Team is on as this is sent away. And this will be taken at the 13. Yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. On the clock in the second quarter of this Super Bowl. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL.
The plays that he provides when he does come alive, when they do look his way, not only is it a big catch, it's a first down.
On first and 10, Mayfield. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes inbounds.
What I love about watching the passing game nowadays is the one dimensional receiver is really starting to leave the game. You've got to be able to do it all. Of course, you've got to run fast. Of course, you've got to catch the ball. But route running savvy and toughness. There's a premium for all of that now.
Hey, one alert!
offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Mayfield hands it off to Chubb. And he's taken down inside the 30. Second of their timeouts. As they stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. First down, Mayfield. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked on down at the 2. These guys have got it back in the closing stages of the first half. If you're a lover of offense, this has not been the half for you thus far. Luckily for me, though, I'm sitting next to a lover of defense. We have had plenty of that, including that interception.
Yeah, and I mean, that still makes it a great game, doesn't it? Everybody talks about if the ball's not in the end zone and points going up on the board, it's not as much fun. I love these defensive battles. Something's got to give with these turnovers. Who can convert it into points?
Seconds to play in half number one. They'll look to throw now on first down. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. He's got it in. Complete. Seconds of the first half, and the Falcons on just 2 plays have taken the lead. McManus's point after is good, and it's now a 7-0 game. So time enough for a kickoff here. 5 seconds remaining in this first half. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Super Bowl. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And I think you'd have to say their coaching staff, all things considered, had to be pleased with their performance in the first half of the Super Bowl. Definitely pleased. Doing their best not to show it to their team, of course, because as you and I both know, their mantra all season long has been finish. Get the job done. They know how close they are to lifting that trophy. One more solid half of football, and they can do exactly that. Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. Adding a safety valve here. That's complete. So the completion good for 6 yards. And that'll bring up a 3rd down.
We see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he lost track of the time left in the play clock. He probably was trying to read the defense and try to figure out which play to run and just lost track, and it cost him.
And the delay of game penalty makes this much more difficult. 3rd and 8.
Something they haven't seen.
Anything to score a point. They field from the gun on 3rd down. This is intercepted. Picked up by Richie Graham. And the Falcons will have set field position here as they take over the 35-yard line. And right about now, you start to think, and maybe they're starting to think, gosh, maybe points aren't going to happen for us in this game.
Well, it's a thought that is worth having because so far in this game, this defense has not just had the upper hand. They've appeared to be a step ahead, maybe even 2 steps, to everything they've done. They've had an answer for everything this offense has thrown at them.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
Coach right now, he always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
And coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. On play action, they'll throw. They'll roll him out right.
Tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
Sometimes
it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has that been
say maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there, just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
Flush to his right. This will be caught by his big wide receiver. Offense at the line, and their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. As he throws, they are incomplete.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Fly it around, making plays on the ball, and we see yet another errant throw as a result. So far on this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure, or do they play coverage on this down? And I would expect pressure here.
One third down, he'll drop the throw. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line.
That was a
two-yard run. The Falcons send out their punter. He's been terrific so far. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Taken at about the 16. A very nice job on the run back there. He'll get 23 yards all told. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. to get started. They had to go a long way on their last drive to score the touchdown. This time, they get at least a little bit more of a cushion with field position.
I have to think that with this field position, after what they did with the last drive, they're going to take a shot right now and try to cut down the length of the drive.
And he's going to be stepped up quickly here. Just a yard after the 39. To begin their next drive, the Falcons' offense at the line. And we're at the time of the Super Bowl where, look, they need points. And they need them badly. Trailing here in the fourth quarter as they begin this drive first and 10. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And life is one that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Greg Newsom. He's had a fantastic rookie season. Made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
But we got to give it one, don't we? For he and his teammates to accept that throw, because for the most part, what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational.
Following the interception, Mayfield. He'll buy some time. And that one drops down incomplete. Good catch. He'll force the ball fully and it's second down.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one. Closed quickly. And he'll force the incompletion.
End zone, Isaiah McKenzie. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. Yeah, last time was a pretty one-pointed interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Get the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. They'll contain him to just four. Second down. Super Bowl, they're going to need this one on fourth down. They throw it out complete. The first down, he winds up taking a pretty good shot that time. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. A gain of six there on first. Passing game as he looks to throw. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Picked up by Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoah. And the Browns are going to have a short field goal as they'll at the 50. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now three interceptions in this ball game.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning. Threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record.
Man, it's caught. Yes, I'm going to tell you. It's gone to the end zone. Touchdown. Great effort there. 50 yards. And the Browns are they extend their lead in the Super Bowl. Lambeau on for the extra point. He knocks it through. It's 28-7. End zone. And he returns this to the 22. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons' offense at the line. Those Super Bowl hopes that they had really dwindling now here in the fourth quarter. That NFC crown that they got 2 weeks ago seems like, and for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Brady Williams picks it off. And you just kind of feel for him right now. Four interceptions, and you can almost see through his face mask. There's a lot going on in between the ears.
There certainly is, and probably way too much, because now he's probably doubting himself a little bit, wondering what adjustments he has to make. But here's what he needs to do. Get through this game, go to the press conference, meet it head on, and show your teammates you're ready to show them what happened today, and you'll be ready for the next game.
And if he can do that as a rookie, that's a great sign of maturity. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Throw left side, there's Schwartz with it. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the line.
Let's go!
This is something you got to be wary of defensively. I mean, just because they're in the mode of trying to burn some clock doesn't mean they won't pass and they got good yardage out of that one.
Yeah, and really, when you're looking at it, now they've got a fresh set of downs. Look for second down. If they want to take another shot and try and loosen things up, that'd be the time to do it.
They'll run with John. Rushing for him now as his big night continues. Good yardage on first down. Now can they punch it in on second and goal? Man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. McKenzie now from his end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Drive the Falcons offense at the line. Let's just be frank, they're playing for pride at this point.
that's all that's left.
And my goodness, another interception. And this return is going to be hunting down at the 28-yard line. And you have to wonder, Charles, in a game like this, 5 interceptions, what does this do to the psyche of a young quarterback?
Well, based on the fact that he's still out there, and he threw a 5th interception. I'm wondering if his head coach believes that he's really strong mentally and wants him to play through it. Because otherwise, you need to get him out and fight another day, because this could leave lasting damage if he keeps throwing interceptions. That's a nice run right there. Able to get to the outside. And so many times, defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence.
And they're going to score again. After the PAT miss. McKenzie now from his end zone. And he'll give it up past the 20 to about the 22. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line.
They are just obviously getting shellacked here on this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget what has happened out here.
Use that as ammo.
Exactly. Take a play into that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today. Coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it, because
you're not going to want that feeling.
No, you don't want that feeling again. And who knows? You may meet up with this team again.
Down, he'll drop to throw it. That one tipped and it's incomplete. A good hands in defensively. That's second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. They'll look to throw here. Eluding the pressure late. And that falls to the ground. Incomplete. Nice job there. Defensively, and now it brings up third down. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. A play-action fake. They'll look to throw. Rolling to his right.
Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always tell you, no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence. I'm not seeing a confident thrower right now. He's off balance. The passing game's off.
And got his man complete. He's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts. As they'll stop it with 27 seconds showing on the clock. Now a play fake here on first down. Throws right side, and that's complete. Falcons going to use their third and final timeout. As the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go in the football game. Scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, it just seems like all game long, there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to find a way to start matching each other's movements.
To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Play fake as they set up to throw. Sliding out of the pocket. He did not keep the feet in bounds, apparently, so that's just going to be an incompletion. The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. Super Bowl champs. And when this moment comes, I think you look back at all the blood, sweat, and tears, the offseason, the workouts, training camp, week one, two, three, all building up now to say you're a Super Bowl champion. It's worth it.
It certainly is, and rarely do we have a team that hoists the Lombardi Trophy that didn't have their share of bumps along the way, didn't have to face some adversity in the journey. And now they get to just enjoy it and revel in it. And all offseason, they'll be signing their autographs with Super Bowl champion underneath it.